Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul,
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up.
On the cross of Calvary about 2,000 years ago. Father, we ask, O Lord, even as we look into your word, before we go into the Holy Communion, Father, I ask, O Lord, that you open our understanding. Father, yes. You need every one of us to know the reason why we are here, and to make us to know that our sojourn here on this earth is temporal. In the twinkle of an eye, we all start disappear from this earth. Father, Lord God Almighty, King of Kings, O Lord, I pray as many of us that we hear your word tonight, open our understanding. Let your word bring life. Let your word bring healing. Let your word drive away every foolishness and spiritual darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, your word says that we are not ignorant of the devices of the devil. We come against every plus and plans of the devil. Wherever they are programmed themselves now, in the first and second heaven, in the land, in the sea, in the air, we hold them bound and we cast them into the pit of hell that burneth with brimstones in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, because you have given us that authority according to your word in the book of chapter 10 verse 19 in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I surrender my body, soul, and spirit again unto you. I come empty before you this morning. Holy Spirit, take control. I know not what to say. As I open my mouth, let the power of the Holy Ghost give me the utterances to speak your word, that I, the speaker, might be blessed, nourished, as your children that will be hearing it will be blessed and nourished too, in the mighty name of Jesus. I come against every spirit of error at the word of God. I bind and I cast you out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, do it again the way you want to do it. I disappear for you to appear. Take absolute perfect control. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brother, quickly, let's turn our Bible to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50, I read from here. It said, now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doeth corruption inherit incorruption. Brethren, what are we looking at tonight? We are looking at flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, this is a little mystery that many of us need to really ponder on. If the body of Christ is able to digest this world, this particular verse thoroughly, we all will get loosed of the world. The way we are holding on to the world so tightly, and we are said we love the man of Galilee. We love Jesus. We are holding on to the world so tight-fistedly, and we are saying we love the world. Many people have faded away from the presence of God. Many people have denied the faith as a result of the storms of life they are going through. Maybe you are looking for a husband and it's not forthcoming, you are giving up. Maybe because you are looking for a wife and it's not forthcoming, you are giving up. Maybe because you are looking for a child and it's not coming, you are giving up. This ought not to be so. Brethren, the word of God is telling you and I that flesh and blood shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Many Christians are failed to realize this fact, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, that we are spirit dwelling in a body. That's why Jesus Christ said, when we make us to understand that we should not be scared of they that kill the flesh, but be scared of him that can kill the flesh and the spirit in hell. Praise Master Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. I read from here. He said, "Fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both the soul and the body in hell." Brethren, what am I trying to bring out here? Jesus Christ is making you to understand. Though they might try to cut off your head, though they might try to do what they do to Stephen, when they were killing Stephen, they thought that, yes, we are going to end him and wipe him away from the earth. But they never knew that he hastened Stephen to enter his glory. Brethren, what are we talking about? This flesh that you are looking at, this blood that is flowing in your vein, is just to sustain you in this little time that you are going to spend on this planet earth. My beloved brethren, let's rethink again. Let's go back again and begin to ask ourselves vital question. Jesus Christ said, "Do not be scared of them that is persecuting you now, but be scared of the one that can kill both you in that can kill both the flesh and the spirit. It can destroy you here, and when you die, he will grab the spirit and also take it to hell." I pray that will not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Bible makes us to understand that in the book of Genesis, God breathed into man, and man became a living soul. Brethren, until God breathed into man, man ceased to exist. Man was nothing. Man was like a mere clay. That is why the Bible makes us to understand we were created in the image and likeness of God. When you are seeing man, you are seeing the glory of God. When you are seeing man, you are seeing the replica of God. My beloved brethren, it's high time we know that we are spirit dwelling in the body. The more you begin to identify this fact, the better for you. You begin to see how useless and useless this world are that we are living in. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. "As the Lord God formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostril the breath of life, and the man became a living soul." You became a living soul. Brethren, you are a living soul dwelling in a body. Brethren, before Adam fell, it was the glory of God that was radiating Adam. It was the glory of God that was clothing Adam. Remember, he said they were naked. In other words, they were not putting on anything. It was the glory of God that was covering them. Immediately they fell into sin, that glory departed. Then there was a curse. Curse was pronounced because the Bible makes us understand the soul that sinners shall die. Though they did not die physically, but they died spiritually. It yielded thorns. Life became horrible. Life became unbearable. People who used to fellowship with God, who used to fellowship with their father, because at that particular time, God, the Bible makes us understand, God came to the garden to always fellowship with them. That closeness was no longer there. There was a distance from them. Praise Master Jesus. But we thank God for his infinite mercy. He killed a sheep and also make an atonement for them, because they said life, the redemption, the life is in the blood. So he make an atonement for them so that their soul will not go to hell. Praise Master Jesus. That is why he said he clothed them with what? With that the sheep coat. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, what are we talking about? Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. You will agree with me, if a person is in a critical state of health or rushed to emergency unit, the first thing that the doctor has to check is the pulse of the person in order to ascertain or to check to check the pulse of the person. If the person does not have pulse, what am I talking about? To check the breathing system, whether the person is still breathing. If this person is not breathing anymore, in other words, if this person is pulseless, the doctor will say we have lost him. The doctor will say we can do nothing. Brethren, the body becomes so vile. The body becomes so useless. Even though you take it and put it under a land trailer to match it, it will not feel it anymore. Even though you throw it in a railway line, in the way of the railway line, he will not feel anything anymore. That is to tell you, flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible makes us understand, according to the preacher man, I'm talking about the book of Ecclesiastes. If you read Ecclesiastes from chapter 1, Ecclesiastes 1 verse 2, it says, vanity of vanity, said the preacher, vanity of vanity, all is vanity. Verse 3, what profit hath a man of all his labor, which he taketh under the sun? I have seen all the works that are done under the sun. Verse 14, the same Ecclesiastes chapter 1, verse 14, he said, I have seen all the works that are done under the sun. Behold, all are vanity and vexation of the spirit that lead to destruction. No wonder the Bible said there is a way that sin may try unto a man. The end thereof is destruction. Brethren, if you know the preacher very well, I am talking about the son of David, Solomon. Solomon was having 700 wives. He was having 300 concubines. Brethren, he tasted what we call pleasure. Solomon was rich in wisdom. Solomon was rich in wealth, but what all? At the end of it all, he came to a conclusion, vanity upon vanity. In other words, we came into this world empty. Definitely, we are going to return. That is why I love Job so much. If you turn your Bible to the book of Job chapter 1, Job chapter 1, from verse 20 to 21, the Bible makes us to understand, after Satan has done his havoc, in order to frustrate Job, in order to make Job to renounce God, in order to make Job to curse God. Look at what Job said here. He said, then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground and worshipped and said, naked I came out of my mother's womb, naked shall I return. Theta, the Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Will you be able to say such a word? Many people are consulting false prophet now because they want the fruit of the womb. When you die, you don't know if you have a child anymore. Many people are doing manipulation to marry. If you die, you don't know if you have an husband before again. My beloved brethren, it's high time we begin to know some certain facts that will make us to be more spiritually focused, that will make us to be more spiritually at a lot, that will make you not to be distracted anymore. You will be focused, and that is what God loves. The Bible makes us to understand in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 33, it says, seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto you. Take a look at Jesus Christ, you and I is looking upon on today. His ministry was just 3 years. He started his ministry at the age of 30 and died at the age of 33. Ask yourself vital question. There was no marriage. He did not build a house. He was spiritually focused. Why? Because he know that he stay. He has a palace that are built with gold. He lives in eternity, not in this temporal life that is being governed by time. Praise Master Jesus. What are we talking about? Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. If you know this, you will know that all the labor on this earth, they are misery to the soul of a man. No wonder the Bible makes us understand. If you go to the book of 1 John chapter 2, when you read from verse 17, from verse 17 to 18, praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If you are with me, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If I am communicating, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
John chapter 2 from verse 15. He said, love not the world. Love not the world. This is what Apostle Paul understood very well. That is why he was able to run his race. He never got married. And I don't know if he built a house. I don't know if he had. He was spiritually focused. And when the time of his departure was at hand, he knew quite all right. You know how they killed him? They cut off his head. Why? Because he knew what Jesus Christ told him. That do not be scared of the one that can kill you, but be scared of the one that can destroy both the flesh and the spirit. Nobody can touch your spirit, man. But if you rebel against God, you will be destroyed by the people of the world, and it will also destroy you in hell. I pray that will not be our portion in Jesus' name. not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Look at the way people are building house. Some people are already building an empire. Some people are already practicing their paradise on earth. The earth that will be burnt with fire, according to the book of 2 Peter. When you read 2 Peter chapter 3, verse, from verse 1 down, do we understand that this world, everything that are in this world, they are the ones that will ignite the fire, that will burn everything down. My beloved brethren, look at what the John the beloved, who were, he was thrown into the hot boiling oil. He was the only the disciple that died a normal death, and God took him to the Isle of Patmos, where he gave him the book of Revelation and said, look at what you are, where you are coming to. My beloved brethren, if you go to verse 16, he said, for all that are in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. Verse 17, and the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. Are you passing away with the world, or you are going to transform in the twinkle of an eye? Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Know this very well. He said, in a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, we all shall be changed. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The word passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Brethren, when you do the will of God, people might look at you now that you are foolish. You are not civilized. You don't know what you are doing. Connecting every day. Brethren, in no distant time, we will know who is foolish. In no distant time, we will meet when we get to Philippi. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, what are we talking about? Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This verse of the scripture is sending a stringent and a strict warning to all who profess to be a Christian, not to be carried away by the fantasy and the euphoria of life that will make you to be grossly carnal, that lead to eternal destruction. No wonder the Bible makes us to understand in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, that the natural man understandeth not the things of the spirit, for they are foolish unto him, neither can he discern them. My beloved brethren, flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Luke 21, verse 34. Luke 21, verse 34. Jesus, we are making you and I to understand, yeah, the thing that we before this head, the heart of meaning is already failing people now. Luke 21, verse 34. Take a look. He said, and take heed to yourself, lest any time your heart be overcharged, your eyes be overcharged. Like my apostle will always say, you are planting house like the way they are planting flowers for you to nourish your soul. You are building house the way they are planting flowers. You are buying car just the way they are buying pure water. My beloved brethren, you have overcharged your soul with surfeity, with drunkenness, and with the curse of this world, so that they come upon you unaware. Watch your soul. I pity some people. Some people say, yes, I have gotten my first degree. I'm going for my second degree. I'm going for my third degree. Okay. That third degree will end up in 6 feet. If care is not taken, it will be used against you in hell. I pray the Lord will help us all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If I take a look at the man Jesus Christ, if I take a man, he's a man. Oh, if we can emulate him, he lived a very lowly life, a low state of life. He was the son, he was called the son of a carpenter. He was so humble. Look at everything. He did not acquire wealth. Even the money that they were using, he was not the one that was holding it. He was being held by John the Baptist. My beloved brethren, take a look at everything about Jesus Christ. He did not buy a car. He lived a very simple life. Only where it was recorded is that they went and brought a sheep or something like that, or a horse that no man has ever sat on, that he sat on. This is just a fulfillment of what was written of him. My beloved brethren, who now gave you that idea of exploiting people, of making merchandise of people in order to satisfy your belly, because your God is your belly? Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Second Peter chapter 2. I love this scripture so much. The day I come in contact with this scripture, I shook my head. That is what is happening today in the body of Christ. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will prosper you. If you can type amen, some people will send some message on WhatsApp. I said, I will reply, I will not type amen. I will not. The person you send this to now, you transfer this message to. If you can type amen, before the following morning, the roof of your house will open and euro will fill your room. Does the person know God? Look at the way people are making the foolery of themselves. Look at 2 Peter chapter 2. I read from verse 3. But there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privily shall bring a damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that brought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. Look at verse 2. He said, and many shall follow their pernicious way. Many shall follow their pernicious way. By reason of who? The way of truth shall be evil spoken of. Truth shall become evil to them. Verse 3. He said, through covetousness. Do you know what is comfort? Covetousness. They want to acquire the whole world. They see you buy a car, they begin to prophesy on you so that you can use that car to sow seed. They see you build a house, they want you to use that house to sow seed. They know that you have just been promoted and your next salary is so fabulous. Your salary is so high. They begin to prophesy now. He said, through covetousness shall they with fair words, deceivable words, words that will lead you to hell, them that will make you to empty your pocket. With fair words, they make merchandise of you. You have become commodity. Make merchandise of you. Whose judgment now? For a long time, lingereth not, and their damnation slumbereth not. I just want you to learn that scripture so that we'll not digress from what we are talking about. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. What are we talking about? These are the portion of those pastors, the pastors that are not preaching holiness and righteousness. Look at what Jesus Christ said. He said, be ye perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect. Some people will say, God understand. What does God understand? What does God understand? When Jesus Christ have come to show us the way, he said, looking upon unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Praise Master Jesus. If you turn your Bible again to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51, he said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. My beloved brethren, it's a glorious thing on that day of rapture. It's not a thing we need to miss, my beloved brethren. It's a wonderful experience that will keep you on toes, that will keep you to be spiritually focused, that will make you to, that will reawaken your spiritual consciousness. He said, in a moment, in a twinkle of an eye, we all shall be changed. Praise Master Jesus. This is the mystery. Apostle Paul understood very well that made him to be spiritually focused and did not entangle himself with the affairs of life. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
For our information, all believers will not die. All believers will not die. And that scripture, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 52, has proven that. He said, in a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and shall be changed. Brethren, I was meditating on this scripture, and something struck my heart. I said, yes, if somebody die now in iniquity, God forbid, or somebody die now in righteousness, your rapture has taken place. Because you know why? You don't have that second chance again to come back to amend your ways, because the one that will take place against judgment is either you are judged, condemned, or you are judged and passed to everlasting life. So, brethren, you can see two things that evolve here. In a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Brethren, If you go to verse 3, it says, for the corruptible must put on incorruption, and the mortal must put on immortality. Brethren, you are going to put on this corrupt body now will be turned. This vile and despicable body will be turned in a twinkle of an eye and put on incorruption. The body will not get rotten anymore. The body can never be defiled anymore. When you die in holiness and righteousness, when your ways pleases God, you will not take that glory, the glory that was upon Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, that glory that will not make you to grow old, that glory that will make you to eat heavenly food, that glory that will make the glory and the light of Jesus Christ to be shining upon you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That is the expectation of every believer. Believer, do not die. No wonder Apostle Paul make us understand. If you read that, said 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 19, he said, if only in this world we have hope in Christ, he said, we are of the men most miserable. If you are serving God because you want to get documents, because you want to get a life partner, because you want to acquire the materialistic things of life, he said, you are of the men most miserable. That is why he said, seek him first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto it. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, the Bible also makes us to understand the method of resurrection. If you turn your Bible to that 1 Corinthians chapter 15, and if you read from 35 carefully, you will get a clearer picture what Apostle Paul was making people to understand there. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 35. But first of all, let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 12 to 19. I take from 12 to 19. He said, now, if Christ be preached that rose from the dead, how say some among you that there is no resurrection of the dead? But if there be no resurrection of the dead, then is Christ not risen? And if Christ be not risen, then is our preaching vain? Your faith is also in vain? 15. Yea, we are false witness of God, because we have testified of God that he raised up Christ, whom he raised not up. If so be that the dead raised not, for if the dead rise not, verse 16 now, there is not Christ raised. 17. And if Christ be not raised, your faith is in vain. Ye are yet in your sin. Verse 18. Then they also which are falling asleep in Christ are perished. Verse 19. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of men most miserable. This is what Apostle Paul was making you and I to understand. People who are doubting, people who are like Thomas, who wants to feel Jesus, who wants to touch where they pierce him before they will believe. He said, blessed are they that have not seen but believe. Paul was making you and I to understand, yeah, that if Christ is not risen, what is the essence of my preaching day and night? What is the essence of the persecution I'm suffering for? What is the essence of me being beaten by the beast, being trapped in the sea, in topsy-turvy, in the tribulations of life? What is the essence of doing this? Because Apostle Paul knew who he meant on the day he was going to Damascus to slaughter the Christians, and when his life turned around drastically, and he became an apostle of God. I pray, as many of us that the Lord has brought to the cave of Adullam, the Lord will grant us understanding in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, brethren, if we go to the verse 35, that verse 35 give a clearer picture. Apostle Paul was making you and I to understand the method of resurrection. He said, but some men will say, how are the dead raised up? With what body do they come? With what body do they come? Look at verse 36. Look at what Apostle Paul said here. He said, thou fool, that which thou sowest is not quickened, except it dies. If you have ever been involved in farming, if you have ever farmed before, you will understand what Apostle Paul was explaining here. Brethren, those days when we go to farm, I will see our father cut a piece of yam and put it into the soil. Within the space of 6 to 8 months, that yam becomes so big and beautiful will come out of it. He said that thing is not quickened except it dies. Jesus Christ, we all saw what happened. Immediately Jesus Christ died and resurrected. He became glorious. He became wonderful. At the same time, he can be here and he can be in other parts of the world. That is to tell you, he's omnipotent, he's omnipresent, he's everywhere. That is to tell you the glory that will be upon you once you die and resurrect and on the last day. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He said, that fool, that which that sweat is not quickened, except it died. 37. And what doeth, and which that so, he said, I'm taking 37 now, and that which thou sowest, thou sowest not that body that shall be bare grain. It may chance of wheat or of some other grain. 38. But God gave it a body as he had pleased him, to every seed his own body. Verse 39. All flesh is not the same flesh. He said, but there is one kind of flesh of man, another flesh of beast, another of fish, and another of bird. 40. There are also celestial bodies and bodies terrestrial. But the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another. 41. There is one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, another glory of the star. For one star different from another star in glory. 42. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is so in corruption, and it is raised in incorruption. It is so in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is so in weakness, it is raised in power. 44. It is so in natural body, but it is raised in spiritual body. There is a natural body and there is a spiritual body. If you can hear me, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I pray, as many of us that the Lord has brought to the cave of Adullam, we all shall possess that spiritual body that will dwell in eternity with Christ in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, if you read from verse 5, so it is written, the first Adam was made a living soul, and the last Adam was made a quickening spirit. That is the Lord Jesus Christ. He's the quickening spirit. He has proven to us that yes, he died on the third day, he resurrected. And same Jesus will resurrect every one of us that day, that live holy, righteous in this body that we are now. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, brethren, what are we talking about? Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. I don't know what you are going through now. I don't know the storms of life that you are facing now. Brethren, the Bible makes us understand. If you turn your Bible again to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, the Bible makes us understand that the suffering of this present world that you are undergoing now cannot be compared to the enjoyment, to the glory that shall be revealed in you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
2 Corinthians chapter 4. I read from verse 8. Apostle Paul, we are making you and I to understand there. He said, we have trouble every side, yet not distress. We are perplexed, but not despair. Verse 9. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Verse 10. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus may be made manifest in our body. Verse 11. For we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus may be made manifest in our mortal body. Brethren, I don't know what you are going through. I don't know the pains you are going through in life. My beloved brethren, you don't need to stay focused, just like the way Job stood focused. Job said, naked I came out of my mother's womb, naked shall I return. Job only understand that he's just a caretaker. A caretaker of a house can be told to leave the house at any time, and you have no power to contend with the landlord. So, in other words, we are caretaker in this body. Whatsoever the Lord has given to you, is it your children? Is it wife? Is it wealth? Just know that you are just a caretaker. In no distant time, things will change. And the question now is, are you going to change to dwell in eternity with Christ, or you are going to change and dwell in hell? The question is left for us. I believe, as many of us that is hearing this word, this hour, we all will change and dwell in glory in eternity in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Brethren, if you go to that same 1 Corinthians chapter 4, you take it from verse 16. He said, for which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, the flesh perish, the blood perish. He said, yet the inward man is renewed day by day through the word of God that you are hearing. No wonder the Bible makes us understand in the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 17. It said, faith cometh by hearing and hearing the word of God. And the Bible said, without faith, no man can please God. No man can please God. That is why the Bible also makes you and I to understand in the book of Romans chapter 15 verse 4. It said, whatsoever that we are written aforetime, that we are written for our learning, that through patience and comfort of the scripture, that we might have hope. Brethren, our hope is in Christ Jesus. Our hope is on the word of God. The renewing of our hope is the word of God. Brethren, if you can grab the word of God, if you can obey the word of God, you can be a noble doer of the word of God. Brethren, your hope will be renewed every day. According to this 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16 that I've just read now. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16. For which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet our inward man is renewed day by day. Apostle Paul was talking here, verse 17. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. My beloved brethren, the ball is in your court. The ball is in my court. If we'll be able to endure this light affliction, in order for us to enjoy the eternal glory that is awaiting us. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you go to that verse 18, it says, why we look not at the things which are seen, but the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Brethren, your sojourn on this earth are temporal. All the cars, everything that you are seeing, they are temporal. But the things that are eternal, that are not temporal, are the things of the spirit. It's eternity with Christ that are not temporal. Eternity in hell is not temporal. Brethren, that is why the ball is in your court. Jesus Christ is doing everything possible to make sure that you and I, we are redeemed, washed, blameless, so that we may be able to appear before him in glory and not in shame. I pray we all will appear in him in joy and not in shame, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, I'm concluding now. If you go to that same 2 Corinthians chapter 5, it says, why death itself has no terror over the servant of the Lord. Death has no terror over us. You know why? Because we are living in a temporal body. We are living in a temporal body. According to that 2 Corinthians chapter 5, if you read from verse 1, it says, for we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building. What is it? The flesh, the blood, everything here. He said, if they are dissolved, we have a building of God, and house not made with hand. A house not made with hand, eternal in heavens. 2, for in this we grow earnestly, desire to be clothed upon with our hearts, which is from heaven. Brethren, can you hear it? I pray none of us will miss our mansion in heaven in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Look at verse 3. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. Remember, everybody that goes to where it goes, they enter here with nakedness. You see, the scripture is complete. It so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked, because when we enter the kingdom of God that day, it is the glory of God that will clothe you, which will be your garments. How wonderful it is that we all look upon unto. Verse 4, for we that are in this tabernacle do groan, be burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon that mortality that might be swallowed up of life. Verse 5, now he that hath wrought us for the same thing is God, who has given unto us the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that while we are at home in this body, we are absent from the Lord. Look at where people want to die now. The Bible is making you and I to understand that we are absent from the Lord. As far as you are dwelling in this body, brethren, that is why when the time comes, I pray we will not die in shame in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Appear before the Maker in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, brethren, is a prayer we pray for. When we are dwelling in this body, we are absent from the Lord. Though his presence is with us, until we are changed in the twinkle of an eye, then we will be as he is, and we will dwell with him in eternity, where he shall be the government of that kingdom that where we shall dwell. That is why the Bible makes you and I to understand. It says, for we walk by faith. How do you walk by faith? Walk according to the word of God, obeying the word of God, living strictly according to the word of God. In verse 10, he said, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the thing done in the body according to that he has done, whether it be good or bad. I pray every good thing that we have done on this earth and his mercy and grace will take us to his kingdom in Jesus' name. Amen. Finally, in verse 58 of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58, he said, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I pray, as many of us that have heard this word, our faith shall be strengthened. None of us shall be weighed down by the storms and the prevailing circumstances of life in Jesus' name. Amen. Taking his holy table, our body, soul, and spirit shall be revived and renewed and reunited with him tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Bless his word in our heart in Jesus' name. Amen. What to you, man of God?
Praise the Lord. God bless you, man of God, and the other woman of God, sister Edith, that was also pretty along when you were pretty along. I was preaching by mouth, and I was preaching by writing as well. Praise the Lord. Brethren, we have heard the word of God in two ways now. One by writing and one by preaching. Pray, Lord, help us. And help us to be the doer of these words in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless both of you.
Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You know you are not born again. This is your hour to give your life to Christ now. Before now, you've been hearing it in one way. Today you have heard it in two ways. If you still go to hell, I've heard it in both preaching and in both writing now. If you go to hell with this, I pity you. Surrender your life to Jesus Christ now. As I'm here, my heart is bleeding. And none of us shall be naked on that day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Prophets, I pray for you. The devil will not ask you to preach this message again in hell in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Whatever that would have made you to make mistake and go to hell, if it's 10 years to come, that would have come your way. May the Lord destroy it today in the name.
Amen.
As I pray for you, I pray for myself, I pray for all the ministers, everyone of us on this mountain. May the Lord will not hear all these messages and go to hell, because it's going to be terrible. Satan is angry with every one of us on this mountain. And I pray will not fall victim in the name of Christ.
Amen.
I did. I pray God forgive you.
Amen.
Please don't do it again. Don't ever. Don't.
Okay, sir.
It's your distraction. Please, I beg you. Sorry. I will stop just now. I'm not happy. Please. And I pray the Lord will have mercy upon you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Say after me, if you want to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word today. Father, I ask you for mercy. Have mercy upon me, Lord. I've decided to leave Satan alone. You have lied and tricked me for so long. But today my eyes are open. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, today as my Lord and personal Savior. I receive the power to go and sin no more. Because I am born again from today henceforth, all things are passed away and all things have become new. Thank you, Almighty God, for sending your Son to come and die for this world to come out from him. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for giving me ear to hear and the heart to do. Thank you, Almighty Jesus Christ, for humbling yourself to come and die for the sin never committed. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brother, sister, if you have confessed this confession, the Lord Jesus Christ, as we are talking right now, is rejoicing while Satan is crying there. Mm-hmm. The holy angels in heaven are rejoicing. The apostles of old, they are all rejoicing. The saints that have gone before us are rejoicing. And I pray we all shall rejoice with them on the last day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray with you, my beloved, that just give your life to Christ now. Father, I thank you. I bless you. I worship you. Father, my soul is bleeding one side. My soul is happy one side. Father, I thank you for this one that I've surrendered to you. Father, my soul is bleeding because some people on this mountain, if kept not taken, they will still go to hell. And my soul is happy that, oh God, you have brought the world so that none of us will have excuse again on the last day. Father, I ask, oh God, you will help every... Thank you, Jesus. Father, you help every one of us, oh God, to run this race again. To run this race, oh God, to the end of time in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, because none of us will be found wanting.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come against every accusing voice.